Hyperdrive offline. Multiple hull breaches detected. Proximity alert. The Ebon Hawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention. The hyperdrive is damaged. Main power must be restored in order to bring the engines online and dock with the nearby Paragus mining station for much needed repairs. Your fate and that of the Ebon Hawk depend upon T3M4, a lone astromech droid. Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue. Press WASD to move. You have new quests. To view your quests, open the gate. Beyond this door is the main hold of the Ebon Hawk. It still appears to be locked down. This room contains plasteel. Beyond this door is the main hold of the Ebon Hawk. This door appears to be locked down due to a hull breach. See if there is an emergency override somewhere in the communication. Some doors can be bashed open or cut open with a lightsaber or cutting tool. Some doors require... This old woman appears to be dead. There is a key card on the body that looks like it opens a locker somewhere. You can hear a banging noise coming from the other side of the door to the storage compartment, but the door is sealed shut and cannot be opened from... While some doors can be bashed open or cut open with a lightsaber or cutting tool, some doors require the use of the security skill to open. Use your security skill from the action bar to open this door. If you need help exploring the Ebon, this lift will take you to the outer hull of the Ebon Hawk, where you will find many parts and mines to use for accessing and repairing the hyperdrive. Use the lift controls to go up. This is the medical room. You are in critical condition. You will need a med pack to be stabilized. Thank you. med pack can stabilize your condition. Success. You are stabilized. To recover fully, you will require the medical facilities at the Paragus mining station. But you are not in any danger of dying from your wounds right now. Console in the cockpit. Scroll through your response options or move the mouse cursor, and then click to select a response. Note that some responses may influence how other characters react to you, so choose carefully. Furthermore, certain skills, powers, and attributes may modify what choices you have, or how successful you are with those choices. CFD is malfunctioning. You can fix him by using a part. Luckily, if you repair 3CFD, he can join your party. Success! You have fixed 3CFD. Now he... 3CFD is now a member of your party. To change which party member you control, click on the portrait or press Tab. Later, when you have more companions, you can add and remove party members. Use the keycard you found to open the locker. The impact armor from this locker can be equipped on the equip screen. To open the equip screen, click on the blaster icon in the top right area of the screen. Sensor droids emerge from this box when you opened it. These droids will make for excellent target practice. Use the weapon from this container to attack the droids. You can equip a weapon from the equip screen. To open the equip, destroy all the sensor balls to continue to the next step of combat training. M4 must equip a blaster before attacking the sensor. Open the equip screen, click on the blaster icon in the top right area. Starboard side of the Ebon Hawk. This open hatch has some parts that will be useful for getting main power restored. This busted engine port has some needed parts for the Ebon Hawk's hyperdrive. Take the parts here back down below to get main power restored. exposed wires control the door to the starboard dormitory. The door is currently sealed, but you can override it from here. Success! The door is opened. You can now access the starboard dormitory through the garage. You have already opened the door to the starboard dormitory. You can get to it through the garage inside the Ebon Hawk. Don't forget to explore the other side of the Ebon Hawk. This is the port side of the Ebon Hawk. The bubbles ahead indicate mines that you've detected automatically with your awareness skill. Some mines require higher awareness to detect. Approach mines carefully. They will blow up and damage you if you get too close. You can use your demolition skill to either disable or recover these mines. Recovering mines requires a higher demolition skill than disabling them, but you get to keep the mine, which you can then use to set as a trap for enemies or break down into components at a workbench. One of the Ebon Hawk's quad laser turrets. They are damaged, but you can scavenge some parts from it to use in repairing the Ebon Hawk. Back inside the Ebon Hawk. This will allow you to dock with the Paragus mining station for full repairs. Success! The hyperdrive is online. Only one step remains. Return to the galaxy map in the cockpit and travel. The port engine is powered up. You can now use the galaxy map to travel to the Paragus mining. To access the area beyond this door, you will have to use solo mode to follow the user. Click the solo mode button at the bottom right area of the screen. While in solo mode, move 3CM to the security computer to open it. This is the main hold. You can hear a banging noise coming from the other side of the door to this storage compartment, but the door is sealed shut and cannot be opened. locker. However, you can use your weapon. Your security skill is too low to open the... Sometimes bashing or blowing open a container will break some of the items in the container, but you can use even broken items. They can be turned into useful components at a workbench. This blast door is magnetically sealed and cannot be opened. This is the main hold. This is the cockpit. Do you want to skip the prologue? To the Paragus mining. The sensors show the door to the storage compartment is being sliced. There is someone, or something, else alive on the Ebon Hawk.